little mini bike update. Drilled some holes in the torque converter cover. And that's working pretty good. Anyways, now I'm working on this, the head tube bearings and stuff. They've never been right. It's like this. There's a small washer that rides on top of the bearing. And it goes through the head tube. And then you're supposed to put this one on there. Well, the problem is that fat washer. These two are mine. Those are extra that didn't come with it. This is looking under the head tube. The problem is this bearing doesn't stick out far enough to have a flat washer that goes all the way to the end of the head tube. When you torque it down, it rubs on that. Actually, you can see right there where it was rubbing on it. So if you crank it down so it's tight and doesn't flop around, what happens is there's too much drag on it. And there's just nothing you can do. I think you're supposed to have another smaller washer down here. That's not, you know, the manual says to put the big washer down there, but that doesn't work, at least on mine. I don't know if this is, you know, the tolerances, you know, this is a little bit too long, or that bearing's a little, you know, in there too far, and not, maybe that bearing is not quite fat enough to stick out enough. You can see how it's the same. So what I'm going to do is go to Hardware Store and get a smaller one. So what I'm going to do is go try to find another one of these and put on the bottom. What I had been running this whole time was I put this one up against that bottom bearing like you're supposed to, or this one, I guess. And then I put these two on there and then put a bunch of grease in between these. And that kind of acted like a really slippery bearing or bushing. And then I tightened it all down. It was basically tight enough and using this so it wasn't causing any drag. And it worked, but it was bad. I actually made this little shim to go inside in between that washer and the tube to eliminate play. I mean, it worked, but it wasn't right. It's never been right from the day I got it. So I'm gonna go try to find another one of these and maybe some slightly different sized ones and see if I can fix that. Should be simple, but it probably won't be. This is the washer that goes on top of the head tube bearing. And this one's the one you're supposed to put on the bottom right next to the bearing, the bottom bearing. Of course, you can see how it just scrapes the head tube. So I'm going to do, these are M10 metric washers. And then I got another one of these, just, I don't know, I got a bunch of extra ones. These are M10 and the thread pitch is 1.25. So I got a couple extra nuts, maybe use a jam nut, I don't know. Got three extra here, and that extra one. A couple extra nuts, just to see, maybe I can fix it. If not, I'm not sure what I'm going to do. So here's what I got going on here. I put a small one where it's supposed to go, right on top of the head tube bearing. And then on the bottom, what it says to do in the manual, it says to put that big one right there on the bearing, but that doesn't work because it rubs against the head tube. So I put one of those smaller ones there and put the bigger one underneath it, and you can see I'm reefing on it a little bit. It's pretty solid even without a nut on there at all. Doesn't move around at all, so we'll see if I can put a nut on there and tighten it up and have it still be nice and smooth like this. Alright, so that's the one that came with it, the smallest washer that came with the thing. This is what I just bought, a bunch of these. And I just ground it down to about that size. A little bit smaller than that one. And if it doesn't work, I'll grind it down a little bit more and see what happens. Cross some fingers. Check it out. It worked. Look at that. It's all cranked down tight. You can see I got my custom washer in there. Look at that. So it was just that bearing or that little washer, big washer, was just rubbing on the bearing, the outer bearing race, and now it isn't, basically. So that's gonna make a big difference. It's nice and solid, more solid than it's ever been, actually, so that's cool. So all I gotta do now is put it back together and take it for a test drive tomorrow, or maybe take it for a test drive tonight. It's pretty chilly out there, but. Pretty cool. Amazing that fixing that front fork tube, the head tube and the bearings, it's amazing how much nicer it feels. And that 60 tooth is, it's really nice, and it still goes plenty fast enough top speed, so I think this is perfect. I think I'm about done with this thing as far as modding goes. Thing I'm thinking about doing is maybe getting 20 inch tires. These are 19 by 7 by 8. Thinking about 20. I gotta adjust my brake. Thinking about getting 20 by 7 by 8s, just to have some more cushion maybe. See, this is a steep little hill right here, rocky. That thing's a little ripper. So much nicer. It handles so much nicer. It's amazing how much difference it is, actually. Yeah, that's a fun little bike. It really rips. Good times.